administration.
Mr. Ortiz-Luis, your thoughts on that rift between what the professor called the House of Marcos and the House of Duterte. Is the business sector closely watching? Is it concerned about it?
Yes, when we are comparing most of the time, no? As I said, there's a lot of improvement in the drug war difference in approach, no? And I think it's more acceptable now, even mm-hmm. the international field. But in the terms of inflation, for instance, as you mentioned earlier, he started in 2021 with about 3-point-something inflation, and then it went up to almost 5.8, I think, mm-hmm. In 2022. But in 2020, it began to taper down, and I think we're now within the target projection of Banco Central of about 2-4%, no? And we're now in the higher end of 4%, but that is a big improvement. And the problem really is the basic commodity, especially rice. I always hear demonstrations saying, he promised 20 pesos. Yeah. He never did, never did. I think when I first heard that, it struck my mind that it was a target that he wanted to be there.
But it was something that stuck in people's heads.
Yeah, but they said he promised. He did not.
It was a campaign promise. Right? Remember, it was an election promise.
I know, right.
No, actually, it wasn't even, he said he will target.
Yes.
He will try to do it.
He just said that belatedly. when they were having difficulty reaching it. But it's still a target of this administration.
And that's the problem. And that's why we have a big discussion now on incomes, salaries, because we have now the highest minimum wage in the region. Mm-hmm. Last year, I think Indonesia was higher than us, but when we came out with last year increase of 40 pesos, we again topped the highest minimum wage in the country. And now we have come up with the new one, another 35, so we're still on top of the minimum wage. The problem with this is, relating it to inflation, is that the prices here are higher, especially of food. And that's the problem why it's very difficult for the labor sector to accept that. And that is why I think demonstration outside is mostly about the legislated wage that they like. Unfortunately, a lot of people, even the politicians, forget that mandated wages only applies to about 10% of the workers. Out of the 52 million in the labor market, only about 10% are minimum wage earners. Mm-hmm. And if you expand that to include the across the board, as they say, including the manager, supervisor, even the president, it goes to about 8%. So 16%, 8% as of 52 million is small. Mm-hmm. So that's mm-hmm. why whenever they come up with a survey and this, you know, they say a lot of people is asking for salary increase, 40%. I think one of the surveys says, how can they ask for 40% increase? They don't even have any employers.
Right.
Who is going to increase the salary of the fisher folks, the farmers, the market bearers, tricycle drivers, jeepney drivers? They don't have. So that if you are going to raise that, they're waiting for income of the family. We come from the government, and that's why we have all this TUPAD, all this help,
right,
assistance.
It's something that's for the people are going to be waiting for to hear from the State of the Nation address and how this administration is going for that. The both houses of Congress have been pushing for a legislated wage hike, but we haven't heard from the president what he wants. Professor, speaking of expectations now, what do you want to hear from the State of the Nation address of the president now regarding that fuzzy narrative that you mentioned a while ago?
Well, of course, this administration is still concerned with the economic issues, as he has said, and we will hear a lot more about the economic policies and programs that he will pursue in the remainder of his term, particularly trying to address the post-global pandemic issue. Because if you look at the different surveys coming out, the number one concern of the public is still economic,
right,
bread and butter issue. And on top of all the surveys, whether it's Pulse Asia, SWS, or Okta, or WR Numero, it's inflation. And of course, inflation is it's a regional and a worldwide issue right now, but it remains to be the problem. And we will expect him to the president to address these issues in his sauna this afternoon.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Professor Mr. Ortiz Luis.